What's this nonsense about needing a password to see Lord Cardigan today?
Relax. I've got it in my pocket.
Look sharp, men. Allow no one past unless I authorize them.
Cardigan has gone too far this time. I've a mind to contact Scotland Yard myself.
Come now, gentlemen. I thought us united in opposition against this perfidious law.
Excellent choice. Hope to see you again.
And shows an adequate sense of the emergency. It shows a sense that...
Pardon me, gentlemen. Sergeant Freddy Aveline of Scotland Yard. Where might this scandalous activity be taking place?
Oh, yes, yes. It's, just this way. Follow me, Sergeant. But discreetly, if you would. One doesn't like to be seen airing a fellow member of Parliament's dirty linen.
What? I'll be very discreet. Usually I would be in disguise, but my clothes all fell into the Thames.
What's happening over there?
Surely such upstanding sentinels of Britannia are not wavering in their duties,
Disraeli supporters
password.
Are rallying.
I beg your pardon.
The assassination
no
attempt.
Password, no passage.
You know who I am? Shame. I'm a member of Parliament, you cretin!
Where would
no
we have
password,
been
no
carbon?
Passage,
we
sir.
We have turned our coats at the first sign of difficulty, blind against the wall,
and shot!
And deservedly so.
Christ, not Balaclava again.
I'm sorry, my lord.
The wind blows.
Password.
Baby apple.
Piss off.
Blast it, damn it all!
Oh. Begging your pardon, my lord. It's time for your meeting with Lieutenant.
Better go see what the commotion's about.
Coward! Villain! Alas, that the hero of Balaclava should fall not on the gloried fields of Crimea, but to an assassin's blade in the very halls of power.
Are you finished yet?
Take your bow, knave! For you have managed what no Russian battery, what no Indian tiger could achieve. Claim your trophy, and may you choke on it.
Yes, but do tell me more about Balaclava.
Farewell. Farewell, dear Britannia. Your dawn shall be dimmer that the Earl of Cardigan sees it not. God save the Queen and the 11th Hussars.
What a prick.
Who? okay?
Apart from the death squad on our tail, apart from that.
Backup's on the way. Why are you pushing yourself so hard? It's not your job to fight Templars.
I had this colleague. He was our boss's son. I didn't much care for him at the start. Everyone treated him like he was so bloody special. To me, he just wasn't invested in anything that didn't affect him personally. But I was wrong about him. He became my friend, put himself through hell, and he saved us all in the end. So I reckon, well, I can't apologize to him, but I can, I don't know, I can try and live up to his example.
You are a good assassin.
Holy jeez!
Hello. It has been too long.
Galena! Blimey, I have not seen you since we blew up that lab in Paris.
There were many explosions and you screamed like a baby. Bishop tells me Otzelberg is here. I will kill him for you.
Super, great news. Now, if you wouldn't mind keeping watch, I am going to lie down and die now.
Rest. We have a big fight coming.
Sean and Rebecca are safe for now, but we're still relying on you to find us that shroud.
A letter? For me? A dinner invitation.
And with whom are you dining this evening?
Maxwell Roth.
The leader of the Blighters? You're not going.
Of course not. Better check the back. I'm here to see Mr. Roth.
Weapons?
No, thank you. I've got my own.
You should be on the stage, sir. This way.
Pass me the base powder. I don't feel right without it.
Ah! Our honored guest has arrived. Come, sit. I've had my eye on you for some time. I find your heroics in battling the great Crawford Starrick quite magnificent.
I've been picking off your soldiers one by one. Doesn't that make you angry?
On the contrary. Surprise is a spice of life. Now, Mr. Starrick, that's a different story. I'm drowning in directives, all terribly boring. Let's say we work together and bring him down.
I'm not so sure about that.
My friend, if I fail to provide you with the chance to cause Starrick some pain, well, you can charge into this theater and kill me yourself.
What do you get out of all this?
The chance to have a little fun with the bravest man in London.
You have a deal.
Lewis, my carriage. Shall we? This way. Well, you don't expect me to go alone, do you? Take the reins. Driver, to St. Pancras. And don't spare the horses.
I thought you and Starrick would be fighting for the same ends. What happened?
You know, he required my services to train his ganglions. But the man is dreadful.
You don't say.
Freedom, Jake. Stealing that is far more than a sin. It denies us our humanity.
Right you are. And St. Pancras will ease our suffering?
The station contains a large shipment of explosives to be dispatched to Starrick and Co.
And you in...
There's a train parked inside St. Pancras.
Then I'm to do away with Starrick's merchandise, leaving chaos in my wake?
Why not, Jacob? Why not? As we speak, the up train is headed towards us. That may help you enter the station unseen.
As long as it remains on the tracks.
I'd say good luck, but you don't need it. I shall make certain any reinforcements from Starrick are kept away from the station.
No.
Where are they?
All right, let's load her up, boyos. Careful with those. Don't want any broken bones tonight.
Someone take care of it.
Throw everything you have to.
There's no way I'll miss it.
Finish him off.
And needs to die.
Took a swig of my pint and needs to die.
All the little piggies have done awful things and need to die.
Hit me! Hit me!
Someday, you blighters will understand that I'm doing this for your own good. Two down. It'd be a shame to stop now. One shipment left.
We'd have been better off if we had these explosives months ago.
That's a fact.
To find somebody to drive this hunk of metal.
If he's not here, where is he? Bring him down!
You'll be singing as if the tune was on the gas.
Get your bleeding!
your hands off me!
What do you think you're up to?
Hush now, please. Do be quiet, sir. No need to make a fuss.
What do you want from me?
I just need you to keep the engine stoked.
All right, I'll help you. Don't hurt me.
Think of me as another passenger. I just happen to have a rather large blade pointed at your back.
Never a quiet moment in London, I suppose.
Created too much noise. I'll need to keep a low profile.
Get your bleeding hands off me! What do you think you're up to?
Would you be so kind as to get up some steam?
Will be on his knees in no time. My hat is off to you. Apologies, I must run. Do come see me again.
Thank you. Take it.
Oh, come on. My mother won't be in for hours.
She has been replaced.
Jacob. He is beautiful, isn't he? I planned a perfect second outing for us.
Have you?
There's borrowing to be done. Three of Starek's henchmen are about to disappear.
Oh, you sly devil.
Oh, and I'm coming along this time. There is no sense in giving you all the glory. Off to my carriage we go, Lewis! Jacob, our carriage awaits. You know how it is. These cowardly fools under Starek have built their own prisons. It's a dreadful waste.
They could be building gangs instead.
No, no. Why build when you can ebb and flow like the sea? I would not aim to pin them down.
Oh, you wouldn't, would you?
I dare say I shall never tire of the National Gallery.
Why does Starek interest himself with art?
He's hired a fiendishly talented woman, one Hattie Cadwallader, to procure works for him. She has excellent taste.
We're kidnapping her for the sin of being Starek's collector.
Oh, my dear, no. We are kidnapping her not because she loves art, but because she finances Starek's enterprises by selling it. One must never mix art and money.
Wait for me with the carriage. I'll pay her a visit.
Splendid. But be careful, my dear. When a deal falls through, Miss Cadwallader tends to poison future sales.
Bring your carriage around and wait for the cargo. I shan't be very long. Someone around here must know Miss Hattie Cadwallader. I'm looking for Miss Hattie Cadwallader.
Ain't seen her. I knows what she's been up to, though.
And what's that?
Friggin' art, sir. She benched a statue not far from here.
The statue must be around here somewhere. Thank you.